In this video, we will discuss the properties of minerals. One of the most important properties is the hardness of the mineral. The hardness of the mineral is based on the strength of the bonds that occur in the mineral. And the way we think of hardness is we have a scale. It's called Mohs hardness scale, and it goes from 1 to 10. As a point of reference, a knife, some metal, has a hardness of 5. The mineral gypsum, this is a piece of gypsum right here, has a hardness of 2. And I can scratch it with my fingernail. It's very soft. The mineral talc, which is also very soft, is number 1 on the Mohs hardness scale. Quartz has a hardness of 7. So you will not be able to scratch quartz with metal, but in fact quartz will scratch metal. And what's the hardest mineral? That would be diamond. And I don't have an example of diamond for you to see right now. Another mineral property is called the specific gravity. The specific gravity is like the weight of the mineral. And let me illustrate that here. I have two minerals. This is galena, which is lead. It's got lead in it. And this is halite, which is salt. They're about the same size. Which one do you think is heavier? Galena is a lot heavier. It has a higher specific gravity. Another mineral property is the shape, the crystal faces, and we talked about that in the intro video. Here's quartz again, and it has characteristic crystal shapes. That's diagnostic of the mineral quartz. This pattern is diagnostic. Another characteristic is called cleavage. Some minerals break where there are weak bonds. Here's mica, which is a good example, illustrates cleavage. Remember, mica has a layered structure. Well, how does the cleavage occur? It occurs between the sheets. There's weakness there, so you're able to break them apart. That's called the cleavage. Different minerals have different types of cleavage. Another property is color. There are different colors associated with different elements and impurities within the minerals. For example, these minerals are both mica. This is muscovite, and this is biotite. Black biotite, brownish or clearish muscovite. Another property is taste. You lick a rock or a mineral, you can find out sometimes what it is. It's obvious what this is, it's halite or salt. And finally, another property of minerals is the magnetic behavior. For example, I have two samples here, and they're attracted to each other, magnetite and hematite. They also make some fun noises when you play with them. These are the mineral properties.